Have you ever wondered where cast members park when they work at the parks in Walt Disney World and how they get to the parks? In this series, I'm going to show you from a cast member point of view as a Walt Disney World bus driver, former bus driver, and soon to be returning bus driver, just where they park and how they get to the parks. It's exciting because some of them take buses that I actually got to drive. I'm going to give you a behind the scenes look at how they got there and what bus they drove. My name is Ichabod Bones, aka the Incognito Mouse, but you can call me Icky. All right, so today we're going to be looking specifically at the Magic Kingdom. And the way that I've got this laid out is I pulled up Google Earth on my laptop and I'm recording with my phone rather than just screen recording. I want to actually record so you can see my hands and I can point to things as I'm recording and show you different secrets and tips and tricks. Today we're going to start with the Magic Kingdom. As you can see, we are right here on Main Street, USA. There's the castle, so I'm just going to zoom out a little bit here. Kind of get more of a top-down view. So you can see here, there's a Seven Seas Lagoon. Over here you see the Polynesian, and this is a transportation and ticket center. So if you know anything about the Magic Kingdom, you know that there's no parking over here at the Magic Kingdom for anybody, guests or cast members, either one. So you just have to kind of park down here at the TTC, which is a transportation and ticket center. Then from there, you have to get on either here, you can get on a monorail right here and go over that way, or you can get on a ferry boat here and go that way. Sometimes, if the monorail is down for whatever reason, or the ferry boats aren't working, sometimes they will have buses running over here. You can see right along here, you can see a few buses there. Some buses will come in here, pick people up and go back out that way, go around past the Contemporary over there, and back to Magic Kingdom. But normally, under normal operating procedures, you'd have to catch the monorail here or the ferry boat there. So over here at the Transportation Ticket Center, parking is here. They have the parking divided into two halves. Pretty sure this half is the villain's lot and this half is the hero's lot. If you've ever parked there, each lot is named after a different particular hero or villain. And over here, this is the Polynesian, right across from Polynesian. This lot right here is called the Woody lot, as in Woody from Toy Story. And this lot is used for cast member parking. You can see here, there's a little bridge that goes across. This building here is what we call costuming or wardrobe, where you go and pick up uniforms, or we call them costumes. So this is a Woody lot, and this is exclusively for cast members. Now this picture is a little bit older. It hasn't been updated because now there's a driveway here where you can pull in and there's a gate. You scan your ID and you get in. Then you would walk across this little bridge over here, cast members would, over here to the Transportation and Ticket Center over here, and everybody clocks in over here, and then they go the different ways, whether they're monorail or watercraft being the ferry boats, also the friendship boats that go over to, you know, Grand Floridian, Polynesian, or over this way to Fort Wilderness, Wilderness Lodge, whatever the case may be. That's where these cast members would park over here. As far as I know, only transportation cast members park in this lot. Like I just said, buses, monorail, watercraft. I don't think anyone else parks over there. They might, but it's kind of a small lot, and there are a lot of transportation cast members. So that's where I would park if I were working at Magic Kingdom. However, most of the cast members that work in the park itself park back way back here. I showed you this before in one of my original videos, my first day at Disney, working when I was at the traditions class. If you want to go back and watch that video, I'll try to put a link up in the corner if I remember, which, you know, I'm bad about that. So anyway, back here is Disney University. Back here where they hold the traditions class, and all back in here, you see all this is where most of the Disney cast members who work at Disney World, Magic Kingdom rather, park. And so, as you can see, it's quite a long way over here to get to Magic Kingdom. So they have to take a bus. And the shuttles, the buses that they take that I and other bus drivers would drive, are the exact same buses that you would see picking up guests in the park. The exact same, you know, white and red and black buses, or the ones that have Mickey Mouse on them or Mike Wazowski or whatever. The exact same buses that pick them up, pick up the cast members. So there's an exclusive cast member route that we pick up, and it's see this little loop right here. It picks up right here. So the cast members would park wherever they park along in here, and they would come here to this building. They would scan their ID to get through a little gate, either here or here. And then there you can see two buses. So a bus over there, but that's like a Lynx bus or a city bus, or over to the Disney college program, I think, housing. So anyway, we would pick them up here, and then we'd head over to the Magic Kingdom. We'd come out this way, and we'd take a left here and just zip right over past here. If you've ever seen the show on Disney Plus where they show all the Christmas decorations that they put away in that big, huge warehouse, that is right here. It is, I think it's this building, or maybe it's this one, Disney's Magic behind. Yeah, this is where the monorails go at night, and the monorails go to get worked on. This is vehicle maintenance bay, so it's over here. This building right here is where they keep all the Christmas stuff. So we would drive along this way, down this road here, and then over there would be back toward Magic Kingdom. You can see there, right there is where they're, see how old this picture is? That's where Tron is now, but right now in this picture, it's all just dirt. They hadn't even really started building yet. So anyway, we would come down this way, go across here through a little security thing, where there's like a little wedge that raises up so you can't go through it until you get security clearance. You'd come through here, and then there was a stop right here. You can see right there. There's also one on this side of the road, on both sides of the road. We would pick people up if they were coming out of Fantasyland or wherever it is. And then the bus would go around this way, and you can see here, this is, I think that's Thunder Mountain, maybe? The backside of it? I'm not sure. Looks like it. But then we'd come around here and loop around the back of this. And then we would, where that bus is right there, this is where we'd drop people off. And if you saw that video that I did way back when I was talking about traditions, this right here, let's see if I can get in there, is the entrance to the Utilidor right there. You can't see it very well in this picture, but that takes you right into the Utilidor. And just for reference, if you flip around this back, once you're in the park, this is Fantasyland. You can see over here is Gaston's Tavern right there, and this is the Beast Castle, Be Our Guest, and all that kind of stuff. And then this, right past there, is where the Utilidors go under, and I've been to those Utilidors many, many times. So the bus would pick and drop people off right there where that bus is, then just loop back right back around. Come over here, there'd be a stop right there. Then this is a circus, what's that land called? Circus Land? I don't remember. Not Toontown, that's Disneyland. Where Dumbo is and all that stuff. We come back through here, keep going straight. Remember, if you went right, that would go back toward Tron. And this is the monorail, where the monorails come in to get work done. And then we just come back here again, same way we just came in, past where they store the Christmas stuff in this building right here. Actually, you can even read that. It says Holiday Services. You see that? You can actually see it says Holiday Services right there. Yep, that's where they keep all the Christmas stuff. Then we will just loop back around here again, come in here, and see, that's a Lynx bus. That's a city bus right there. We would just drop off here, and then just go back into the whole loop again. So the cast members would park here, most of them here. And then from there, again, when they go into the Utilidor over here, then from there, the Utilidors, you know, they go in right there, and then they kind of, you've probably seen the pictures before where they come in and they branch all the way around and they branch out so that they can go anywhere. There's one main vein artery that goes right under the castle to the front, and then it loops around, and then there's like spokes underneath. So you can get pretty much anywhere you want. And then they can just sneak up stairwells all throughout the Magic Kingdom. But this is where Magic Kingdom cast members would park. Either back here, they call this West Clock. That's what this area is called, West Clock. And then they would come back here to the Utilidors and go in that way. Or possibly they could park over here in the Woody Lot. I think that's only transportation cast members. And then they would clock in and go their merry way from there. So the cast members of Magic Kingdom have to give themselves plenty of time, because to get to drive their car all the way back here, find a spot, get through security, get on the bus, get all the way over here, walk all the way to the park, wherever they need to go. It can take them, you know, 30, 45 minutes. So if you're running late, you better give yourself, if you're working at Magic Kingdom, rather, you better give yourself plenty of time. So that's not Big Thunder Mountain. Big Thunder Mountain's way over there. I don't know what this is. It's just kind of a rocky facade. I think that's, yeah, just some kind of waterfall there. But anyway, they got to give themselves plenty of time. So that, boys and girls, is where Magic Kingdom cast members park and how they get to their location. Tune back in tomorrow and we will go over my favorite, Epcot. Epcot has the most extensive cast member transportation system because it's huge and they don't have Utilidors per se like Magic Kingdom does. So they have to give themselves even more time than Magic Kingdom cast members do. So come back tomorrow, you'll see where Epcot cast members park and how they get to their work location. It's going to be a lot of fun. Thanks for coming around. And remember, Wasiona hope, Waswahili, for they who have no fear. Hurry back.